Hi, welcome to Pictures, Wood and Words. I'm Hedgy. What do you think? New intro? No? That's okay. Forget that then. Right, I'm going to make another thing. I make all sorts of things, but mostly they're not worth recording, so I don't record them. But I'm going to have a go at a larger project, and this is to make a vase out of engineered wood. So, what's engineered wood? Engineered wood is this stuff. It's a ply. So if you know what plywood is like thin layers of wood glued at 90 degrees to each other. So you've got one there, one there, one there, one there. And it's very, very strong and very dimensionally stable. It doesn't contract and expand much and all of that. You know, it's very solid and stable. Well, this stuff is like that, except that the top layer, the top, I don't know, 3-4 millimeter layer is made out of the actual wood that you'd want your flooring made of. So in this case, I have two rooms in my house that have an oak floor, and that's real oak, but underneath it is this engineered wood. So you end up with an oak floor made out of real oak, but it's very dimensionally stable, so it doesn't expand, it doesn't contract, it doesn't take a load of looking after, and most importantly, it doesn't cost you an arm and both legs. It only costs you an arm. So I watched a video by somebody called Andy Phillip. Andy Phillip's a professional at doing this, and I'm a numpty, so don't forget that. So if you want to see what I'm going to do done professionally, go and watch his video. He made out of plywood, and plywood is softer than this stuff. But I just happen to have a box of this sitting in my garage for about 3 years, having had a couple of rooms in my house done with this flooring. So I got what I had out, and I'm going to make it into a vase, or I'm going to kill myself doing it, or, you know, somewhere in between, perhaps. I don't know if this is going to work out. I've cut a little bit out, which is why I've got this funny shaped piece, but I haven't done it yet. Let's see what happens. Thank you.
Right. I just need to interject something here. I haven't caught this on camera, but I was just trying to hollow out inside the end here, which is the most dangerous bit, because it means I have to detach this. So the only thing holding the whole thing in is this bit here. And it got a wobble, and it came off the lathe at about 1400 RPM, and it hit the floor, and it broke in half. And I said, "Oh, that's a shame," or words to that effect. So I've repaired it, and luckily, by the nature of the material I've made it of, I've managed to repair it. It'll be pretty much, well, not pretty much, it will be invisible, so that's fine. But what it means is I had to remount it on the lathe. And you can't remount things on lathes perfectly. At least, I cannot, let's put it that way. So it isn't perfectly central. So this end here, you're going to see when I start it up, because I just need to sand it all. You'll see this end is going to wobble like this because it's running eccentrically. Because you just can't center it the same as it was when you made it. Does that make sense? So if you're wondering why this is wobbling, it's literally because it flew off, broke in half. I had to repair it and recenter it on the lathe. So, you know, there's that.